Malaysia Cup semi-final side. They'll be a force to reckon with, especially on the break, what with a lethal duo of Hashim Mustafa and Marko Kraljevic. And watch also for Wan Azila, the Ecuador. This year's squad, ESV Sundramuthi, in the prime of his footballing career, his dropping was greeted with displeasure from a lot of areas, most notably from former coach Ken Worden. Sundram though will add the skill factor to this tenacious Kelantan side. In the Singapore lineup this evening, what with Malik Awap and Michael Varner failing late fitness test, Singapore will have to bring on Saswati Mazatazuki and Nordin Khalil. Both Nordin and Lee Man Hon, who plays in left midfield, will be making their debuts in the Premier League for Singapore. Kelantan, with Sundram adding that bite and also them retaining 8 of their first 11 from last year's Malaysia Cup final, Malaysia Cup semi-final side, they'll be a force to reckon with, especially on the break, what with a lethal duo of Hashim Mustafa and Marko Kraljevic. And watch also for Wan Azila, the acquisition from Terengganu. The strike force must be feared. The referee for the evening, K. Nataraja from the Armed Forces. He visited the National Stadium twice last season, refereeing the matches against Perlis and Pahang. So it's a 5-3-2 formation played by Singapore, and a typical Milos Kovacek formation for Kelantan, 3-2-3-2. My name's Mark Richmond, and it's been quite some time before I've been in this box with Jamie Reeves, who is with me this evening again.
Yes, good evening, Mark, and it's a very exciting start to a new season. I like the new look to the Malaysian League with the 16 teams, so there are a lot more games to enjoy. Gives a chance for the season to unfold. Last year you lost one game early on and it's difficult to make up.
Well, judging from the early signs in the Singapore team, Abbas Saad will come back down to midfield to partner Nazri and Manhon, while Nordin Khalil and Fandi Ahmad will be left up front to strike. Borhan makes his return to Malaysia Cup football with a pump up front. It was a frustrating season indeed for Borhan last year. Sundram tried a little dummy over Abbas. Before that, Saswa couldn't get past goal. Fundy, he scored last season's opening goal for Singapore. He's trying to just slice his way through the Kelantan defence then to no avail. Good work by Wan Azila. Unfairly challenged by Nazri Nasser.
Yes, in the open exchanges, someone like Nazri Nasser is always going to get in there and make a few challenges. Nice run from Fandi there. Was tackled fairly on the edge of the box. The crowd appealed for a penalty, but the referee was quite right not to give it.
Hashim Mustafa from Qamri trying to float it inside once again for Hashim Mustafa. But not a very easy ball for the experienced Kelantan forward to get. Singapore though concede a throw-in. And as you can see, a lot of them returning to see how much damage Sundram can do to his former teammates. Manhon kept the ball in play well. Abbas couldn't reach it. Wan Azila gets the ball again. He's seen a lot of the opening exchanges, Wan Azila, for Kelantan. Here's Hashim. Zamri. Zamri once again just banging the ball inside. Saswa with a very poor clearance. David Lee gathers it easily. It's been a long time since we've seen David Lee in action for Singapore there.
Yes, and of course it's going to be quite a big night for him as well. He's a very experienced player, but he'll still be nervous coming back into the National Stadium, appearing in front of all these people again. And with something to prove, there are a few people who think that his reflexes aren't all they might be nowadays.
Okay. Decides to go throw in. Abbas, who started the game in a central midfield position. Manhon leaves it for Saswa, flicks it inside for Fandi Ahmad. Trying to get the ball through to Abbas Saad, who still manages to keep the ball. And a mix up then between Wan Azila and Wan Kamaruzaman Muhammad, resulting in Wan Azila blasting the ball out for the first corner kick of the game to Singapore.
I think there is a suspicion that this defence can be got at, but they're not the greatest defenders in the world. And there was a lot of panic there as Abbas chased the ball in.
At the far post, almost getting there. Bundy Ahmad. He wins another corner though. It's a nice flick on. They've been working on their set pieces in training, and that was one of them. A corner to the near post, flicked on by Nordin Kalil, and Fundy Ahmad almost got at the end of it. Good defending though, clearing it for a corner.
Yes, the coach will be very well pleased with that, and I suppose that's due to Ken Warden's efforts. Let's see what they can do from the other flank this time.
Fundy almost a straightforward hitter this time. One couple of someone has got no problems at all, although he will buy a little bit more time by going down after the challenge, the head collision with Lim Tong Hai.
I really don't like to see that, Mark. I thought Lim Tong Hai just went for the ball, and I don't think the goalkeeper's seriously hurt. He's rolling around there as if he's been shot or something.
Well, the last time Singapore played Kelantan right here at the National Stadium was way back in 1991. And that time, Singapore beat Kelantan by 7-0. They almost went ahead with this corner kick.
It's a nice near post corner. There's a good flick on there. And excellent run from Fundy. And the defender did well there, actually managed to jump just in front of Fundy. And that's why it took the deflection. Would have been superb for Singapore to get a goal as early as that. Settled a lot of nerves.
Great ball, superbly passed by Wanazila. Zambi trying to just curl the ball into Hashim Mustafa, and then straight to the body of David Lee though. Good work by Kelantan, showing signs that they can attack on the break. And perhaps that's what the tactically drilled to do so this evening by Wiley coach Miloš Kovacic, to contain a very eager Singapore side, and then perhaps to score from the break from their vicious attack force.
Well, I think that's the tactic we're going to see at the National Stadium all through the season. Teams will come here basically to defend and to try and play on the break. And Singapore have got to be prepared for that. So having five defenders, they should be less vulnerable to the fast break than they were last season.
Nazri Nasser hasn't really touched the ball yet. He did for an opponent though. Manhon, well trapped. Can get past the Kelantan defence. Finally, it's Saidi Napia who clears it out of touch for a throw into Singapore. Yes, the cheers ring out for Douglas Moore. And the job was left vacant after the sudden departure of Ken Warden. He willingly stepped in. And it's an unenviable task, I can tell you, Jamie.
Well, yes, it was a useful man to have on the spot at the time. A vastly experienced coach. Someone who could pick up the reins and hopefully do a very good job for the team.
Nordin tried to just dummy the ball. Nazri will not keep the ball down, and it goes out for a goal kick to Kelantan, but a very bright opening indeed by the team in red.